Hey guys, it's John from TCB here with TCB on the Streets again. Today I'm here with John, the owner of Philly Gains, which is here in the Roxborough section of Philadelphia. He's a small business. One location, John, is that right?
A couple locations, so you're over here.
Okay, sorry.
So we have a couple gyms, some satellite locations, one in Downingtown, PA. We have our home office at Ridge Ave in Roxborough, and then we have a place in Northern Liberty, a little satellite location.
Oh, nice. A little more enterprise than I was aware of, so I learned that by coming out and talking to John in person, which is what we like to do when we shop small. So we're here for TCB on the Streets, just asking people, business owners and other people, just regular citizens, how do you feel? Do you feel powerful as a citizen? So that's my question to you today, John. Let me make sure I point the camera directly at you. Do you feel powerful as a citizen?
I don't always feel powerful as a citizen, no. But what I do is, as a small business owner, I kind of make sure that I shop and support other small businesses so that we are distributing the wealth equally around and like helping out. We're not just having like one conglomerate taking in all the wealth and then having a monopoly. So that's kind of what I do.
You know, it's very cool to hear a business owner themselves talking that way, because what it does is it ties into the idea that we can decide where the wealth goes. People get mad and they want, say, the government to redistribute wealth, or they say, like, you know, eat the rich, like it's like evil, good against evil. But every one of us can decide where we put our money, where we put the power. So if you want power concentrated, you can buy it from Monopoly. But if you want, like John's doing, spread it around to local small businesses. So it's a great idea. And, you know, I'm sure you appreciate when residents come in here and support you.
Love it.
But the funny thing is, too, is like, it's probably obvious to you guys that John is a bodybuilder. Actually retired, right?
I'm a washed up bodybuilder.
Well, I'll take that over, you know, whatever the heck I am right now. But anyway, John, when you built up your body, like obviously you use the power of strength and power to make yourself stronger physically, and you feel stronger probably than the average person, and you just are. I know some of your numbers that, you know, you can put up with weights, but do you feel as powerful of a citizen? Like, some citizens feel like weak, like their vote doesn't really do anything, for instance. Do you feel as powerful as a citizen as you do physically?
No, I don't.
Okay.
But, I mean, not to get too political, but after the last election, I don't feel like my vote is very powerful.
Okay. But was it just that election, or was it other elections?
I mean, it's other elections, but yeah. It's just more, my memory is just fresher off of that one.
Yeah.
So, but it is important that we do vote. Everyone has a vote. It's our duty to do so. And at every level. So not just, you know, voting for a president, but voting for representatives, voting for like your mayor, or your just, you know, your state representative, your local representative, just vote.
And I think that, to use an analogy, since John's a bodybuilder, when you're injured and you're serious about training, you keep working out, you work out around that injury. You don't just disregard it. You don't injure yourself further. But everyone, I think, would realize that our voting system is a little bit broken right now.
Sure.
But you keep voting anyway, because it gets more broken when you completely stop. So you probably, it's rare that you have an injury so bad you completely stop training. I think every bodybuilder I know trains around.
You can't complain about a problem if you're not trying to fix it. So if you're complaining about who you don't like in office, either side of the system, it doesn't matter. If you're not voting, then you're not doing something proactive to fix the problem that you think is visible.
So it seems like a lot of people are seeking an external solution. Like they want like term limits or something, that they don't have to do any work. They just want the problem to go away by term limits, or they want the problem to go away by this next guy that gets elected. You mentioned the local elections. I think a lot of people don't realize that that's very important, a powerful way to exert pressure on the entire political system. They know you're watching what they're doing, because you can be close and know those guys personally. So I think what you're saying is right on, is that you keep voting anyway, even though it's currently maybe feels a little broken, because rather than term limits, if we can get 100% voter turnout in the local elections too, and at Citizen Body, we want to help people be able to do that more readily and easily so that elections don't feel so disconnected or complicated, like for judges and things like that. People get confused about looking at that ballot. But you shop small, sounds like you vote. That's important. What about information, news, things like that? Do you feel powerful in the information you can get?
I don't watch the news.
You don't watch the news?
I think there's too much bias.
Okay. So how do you get your information about what's going on?
I don't. Honestly, I don't. All right. I mean, I'll watch the news. You know, you pick and choose which side you're watching according to your political affiliation, I guess you would say.
Okay. But you feel a little bit disenchanted with media and the news in general, right?
Yeah, I don't. Okay. I think that there's agendas.
All right. So Citizen Body, we have a couple recommended sources that aren't perfect, but we think they're as neutral as you can get. So they're like, here's what happened. Here's what was said. Have a nice day. They don't try to sway you to some side. So I think you might want to check those out. And everybody else, check out our website for recommended news sources. They're not perfect, but we think they're the best among the worst. And then the last thing is, what about in the world of, say, entertainment? You know, you see these huge entertainers, you see sports, you see these huge spectacles. Do you draw inspiration from the giant entertainers, or do you ever do what we call art small, which is like maybe like local music, local acts, comedians, things like that? It's not something people think a lot about, but where you draw your inspiration and what you admire and what you kind of aspire to is important. Do you ever think about that, or is that something like a new idea to you, the art small?
I'm so caught up in building my own businesses with my gym out in Downingtown and the stores and stuff like that, that I'm not involved in the local, you know, any kind of recreational stuff like that, but I don't have too much of an opinion on that.
And people with businesses, if anyone out there thinks that it's not more work, it's probably twice to three times the amount of work as if you have a job. John, can you attest to that?
It's not even a job, it's a lifestyle.
Yeah.
So there is no like, this is my scheduled shift and this is when I'm done. You're always working.
Yeah. And every time I come in the store, pretty much John's in here. So.
And that's not saying that anyone's job is not important. That's not saying anyone works harder than anyone else. Anyone's less passionate. It's just, that's through the lens that I view life through because it's mine.
And anyone that owns an enterprise takes an ultimate responsibility legally. They take a responsibility financially. And so it's just more work. I think a lot of people have this notion like, I want to be my own boss. Like it's this easy path. But I think you can attest that having your own business is actually...
That's one of the most frequent things I hear when I talk to people or I meet them out. They're like, I always wanted to open my own business. And a lot of people get like gassed up and they're like, I'm going to start this. And you see them just kind of like... They don't go the distance, or they just kind of like, for lack of a better term, kind of crap out very early on. So it is a very different, special type of person that it takes to be a business owner, because you can go to school for something, but like there is no journal of like medicine. You can go to school to learn to be a surgeon, but like being an entrepreneur, it's kind of just like you're just absorbing as you go. It's crazy.
And I think the reason that the business failure rate is so high is because our culture has a lot of hype in it, a lot of sentiment. Like, if you can dream it, think it, build it, they will come. But it's very short on calibrating expectations to the realities of the obstacles that you're going to face.
No one owes you anything. No one in life owes you a goddamn thing. You have to build a brand, and then you have to... you know, indoctrinate people so much so that like they want to buy into it, so that they want to support you. It doesn't help, you know, or it doesn't hurt to be a good person, and have like a, you know, good moral high ground in terms of like what you're selling people, and you're not just like ripping them off, and you're building trust and community. But no one owes you anything. So like, just because you make the nicest building or you have the greatest business, it's not a guarantee that you're going to be successful, because, you know, again, going back to what we talked about earlier with like, it's very easy for someone like an Amazon, and you just order from Amazon as opposed to coming to my store and buying supplements. So, you know, we have an uphill battle against industry like that or a corporation like that. So we have to work twice as hard to get less of a profit because, you know, someone actually has to walk here. They have to shop here. And it's because of like the community that we built. So yeah, lost my train of thought, but that I was going somewhere.
It's okay. I think the bottom line that we took away from that is that it's a lot of hard work. And I think being a citizen, people have forgotten that if they don't do some work, just like this body doesn't come from doing nothing, that you're not going to be powerful as a citizen if you don't do anything but push a button every 4 years or even every 2 years, or just hope that what the news is telling you is all you need to know and all you need to do is jump on a red or blue team. It's the theme, I think, from this interview here, John, today, this brief one, is that everything that you get power from and you get strong from is a lot of work. Would you say that's fair?
Yeah. I mean, iron sharpens iron. You know, anything that's worth anything in life is something, you know, you have to work hard to achieve it. That's what makes achieving it feel good.
And I think guys and gals, I think, can both relate to everyone in the back of their mind when they go to that gym would kind of like to look like this. But they sort of realize that either A, it's too much work, or B, they don't have the genes. And so, or the discipline.
Discipline is everything.
But we can all look a little bit better if we do get to the gym. And what we're saying at TCB is you can look and feel more powerful and better as a citizen if you do a little bit of the work.
If you take care of your life, you become a better citizen because then you'll be less dependent on the government to help you with things.
I don't think anyone dreams when they're graduating high school of being dependent on anybody. So anyone that can utilize the talents that they have and the health that they have while they have it to be as self-sufficient as possible can only be a good thing. But, you know, we obviously need safety nets in place for people that, you know, get injured or sick or, you know, have disabilities. But as a citizenry, we have gotten pretty weak, and that's what Power Citizen is all about. So I don't know if you have any more closing thoughts, John. You want to talk a little bit about your store, what you supply here, bodybuilding tips?
No bodybuilding tips.
I try to get them for free.
So we're Philly Gains. I've been around for about 8 years in the Roxborough area. We sell vitamins and supplements similar to the larger chains, but I own the store, so I don't have any vested interest in selling you anything or any one particular thing. So we like to, when you come here, we ask you what your goals are, and then we work off of that, and also what your diet is, because supplements do that. They supplement your pre-existing diet. So supplements aren't the be-all, end-all, but they are a very good complementary component to diet and training. So we lead with honesty, we don't upsell, and that's how I'd rather someone come in here, they buy one thing instead of me selling them 20 things, and then they never come back because they're like, it doesn't work. So if you're interested, come on in, 6011 Ridge Avenue, C1, Philadelphia, PA, 19128.
And if you are local here in Philadelphia, Roxborough, that's across the street from the Starbucks on Ridge Avenue. And next to, I think it's Epic Church. Is that the one right
next Epic to? Church? No, next door, they're opening up a cookie shop.
Cookie shop? Nice. Wow. So you can get cookies and protein.
You can gain weight and lose weight in the same shopping center.
And by the way, I will tell you for John's place here, I come in, I'm just a regular guy. You don't need to be a bodybuilder to come in. If you just want to, you know, if you just do like a little bit of exercise, you can come here too. He never kicked me out once. So, all right. Well, thanks, John. Appreciate that. Everyone keep Philly Gains in mind and stay tuned for more tips on how to be a power citizen. Take care.